staying with Sharad and I on Consider This. Liu Chin-tong is a Dewan Negara Senator and the Political Education Director for DAP. Chin-tong, thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you.
Can we first address the absence of PKR at the post-Parliament Pakatan Harapan press conference earlier today? Now, is this evidence of the same fractious dynamics that plagued Pakatan Harapan during its 2 years in government?
I think we don't read too much into the presence or non-presence of Dato' Sri Anwar. But I think it's very important that Pakatan holds together whatever MPs that we have, together with Tun Dr. Mahathir as well as Warisan, so that we can eventually form the government. We are very close, and it is very important to hold together so that we can reclaim the government.
Chin-tong, you know, from today's proceedings, people are reading into the seating arrangement the majority that the Prime Minister is suggested to enjoy. I mean, what do you understand by the seating arrangement, and what do you understand that majority to be?
Basically, after the press statement of Sri Aman MP, Muhyiddin only has 113 MPs on his side. And that is based on the sitting arrangement. But that has not been tested on the parliamentary floor. See, the reason why Parliament has to call for a proper meeting is that it will allow the MPs to test the majority of the government. Now, the government is now worried and not prepared even to test it and even to allow for any procedural vote. Is it...
But would you agree, yeah, Chin-tong, that it looks like the Prime Minister does in fact have a majority, slim or otherwise? It is a majority. Question is, what is the point of a motion of no confidence if he does in fact have a majority?
Because it has not been tested. The moment it is put to a vote, he may not have the majority.
I mean,
so
what
it had to be tested.
What would happen? What would have to happen for people to cross over to the Pakatan Harapan side? I mean, is it just moral suasion, as expressed by Tun Dr. Mahathir, that is going to change the dynamics, to change the numbers?
Well, people are not happy with the arrangement. Many MPs did not know that they will be signed up by their leaders into this makeshift coalition without a purpose. The only purpose of this coalition is that it is anti-DAP and it is put together because it wants to deny Anwar Ibrahim a chance to be Prime Minister. So the point is that some of them are not happy and they don't think this is something that they actually sign up for. So to go to the parliamentary floor is to give them a chance to say that we actually did not sign up for this this government.
Do you expect that to happen in July?
Well, actually, any parliamentary day, any vote is an opportunity to test the majority of the government. And the government can only delay parliament as long as until budget. I mean, I'm not sure whether the government will call the July sitting, because any parliamentary vote will have a danger, will pose a danger to the government, in which the government may not have the majority, and you will have to resign from government. It will have to allow the king to appoint a new prime minister. And therefore, I think they will drag as long as possible. So I'm not confident that they will call a July sitting. However long they want to drag, they cannot drag beyond budget 2021. Because if they drag beyond budget 2021, the government will have no money to spend in the next year.
Okay. Chin-tong, before we move further, I'd like to come back to something you said a little bit earlier. You said that right now, the focus, not to read too much into Anwar Ibrahim's absence at the press conference earlier today. You said right now the role of the opposition is just to hold together. I'm wondering then, what should we be reading into, if not this? What evidence do we have that the fractious dynamics that in the Pakatan Harapan coalition has been worked out?
I think eventually, we will have to come to a consensus. What would be the best way for the nation? I think the best way for the nation is to bring together a coalition that coalition was actually given the mandate by the people to run the government. So eventually, Pakatan Harapan, together with Tun Mahathir's faction as well as Warisan, will have to come together to form a solid bloc in order to reclaim government.
I mean, Chin Tong, it's very nice to talk about the restoration of the people's mandate. It sounds like it was stolen from Pakatan Harapan. But isn't it true that Pakatan Harapan squandered the people's mandate, that in fact you lost that mandate?
I think we knew that this was difficult because this was a coalition of former rivals between Mahathir and Anwar, and also it was not just an opportunity to form a new government. It is not a usual change of government like those happen in UK or in Australia, but it was actually a transition from an authoritarian government. So that transition is difficult. I don't think we have enough time to build democratic institutions to consolidate democracy. So because of that, and because of the internal dynamics of a coalition put together in order to fight kleptocracy, we must admit that this was a difficult coalition to manage, and it was also difficult because it was a new democracy with media being free, but ownership is still controlled by friends of the former regime. So we were managing something very difficult. We didn't do very well, but that is something that I think we'll do better after this.
Okay, well, given the limitations, Chin Tong, of this parliamentary sitting, how exactly will Pakatan Harapan plan to be a vigilant and a vocal opposition?
I think Pakatan and Warisan, as well as Tun Dr. Mahathir's faction of Bersatu, will have to prepare for governing. You will have to tell the people that we have better ideas and we have better experience. We are more stable. When we come back, we'll be more stable because we have a common purpose. This is a coalition at least governed by similar ideas. I mean, this is a coalition that at least subscribes to the idea that corruption is not something that we agree to, and corruption is something that we want to eradicate.
So, but Chin Tong, wasn't that exactly what was the run-up to the last general election, the eradication of corruption, the fight against Najib Razak? I mean, if that didn't in itself, keep the coalition together, why should that change now?
Well, because at that time there were four prime ministerial candidates. Tan Sri Muhyiddin wanted to be prime minister, Azmin wanted to be prime minister, and within Bersatu there were dynamics between Tan Sri Muhyiddin and Tun Dr. Mahathir. Within PKR, there were dynamics between Afrin Ali and Anwar, and there were factionalism, and those factions came together to create what they call the Sheraton move or Sheraton coup. So I think at least now it is clear that you don't have those dynamics happen now.
Okay, Chin Tong, the last half minute that we have, the legal challenge to this political, this parliamentary sitting, what do you make of that? Do you think it's going to work?
I think eventually, if there is a clear number, then change will happen.
Well, all right then. Thank you so much for speaking with us tonight, Chin Tong. That is all the time we have for you on this episode of Consider This. I'm Melissa Idris, with me Sharad Kutan, signing off for this evening. Thank you so much for watching, folks, and good night.